No, everyone, it's not that kind of pass holder they're talking about. This isn't Walt Disney World. This is the Dwight D. Eisenhower Executive Building. Right here on the other side of this building is the famous West Wing of the White House. And of course you've heard that a lot of people work at the White House. And you wonder, how can so many people work at the White House? It's really not that big. Well, that's because actually, in reality, many of the people that work at the White House work in this executive office building right next to the White House. Technically, they're not in the White House, they're next to it. In this building. Yes, it's the famous Pennsylvania Avenue that runs right past the White House. Let's go take a close look to see what kind of action is going on right outside the White House. As most people know, they've closed off Pennsylvania outside the White House years ago. All these barricades are here, but you can still walk down here and get a pretty close look. So there's plenty of little tour guides and groups, and doesn't seem too busy today. This is Lafayette Square right here. Hard to see right there, but there's a statue on horseback of Andrew Jackson. Lafayette himself was a French hero who came over, became a hero of the American Revolution, and this park is named after him. And here is, of course, the White House. Lots of armed guards protecting it, looking out. Last time I was here, you could walk right up to that fence and, you know, literally just put your camera right up to the fence and get a great shot, unobstructed by any barriers, and get a beautiful shot of the White House. If I can find that in the archives, I'll show that picture. And we also took a tour inside the White House some years ago. And that was really interesting. I really enjoyed it. The last time I'd been in the White House, I was a little kid. So, took a lot of years to actually schedule. In order to actually go into the White House, you have to contact your congressman and get them to make an appointment for you or something like that. You know, Mary took care of that. My wife took care of that detail. But so people making a political statement here. I've seen it much busier than this. I've been here many times. Like a little maybe news program going on here. Channel 10 News doing something. Beautiful cherry blossoms right there. It's coming into that time of year for cherry blossom season here in Washington, D.C. Just as there's a long lawn that faces in that direction towards the Washington Mall, the George Washington Monument, the Capitol Building on the left, the Lincoln Memorial on the right, and next to the Lincoln Memorial is a few other memorials, the Martin Luther King Memorial is next to it, the Vietnam War Memorial, but there's a straight shot here with nothing's in front of it until you get to the mall. It's a big long line that goes that direction, and then if you swing around in this direction, you'll see that they do the same thing in reverse. You see this long swath that goes really far with nothing built all the way down there except road. Very impressive. Impressive. Most impressive, as Darth Vader would say. And that right there, of course, is the famous West Wing. The Oval Office faces the front, so we're facing the backside. We We have a gentleman right here on the left. I'm not going to show you what his sign says because it's got some bad words on it. Let's just say he doesn't like Trump. Not even going to show you what his sign says. It's pretty disgusting. But here we got something different. All right. This guy's got quite the thing going on here. And of course, there's the awesome, popular photo opportunity that's presented here. We have others out here that are evangelizing. It's a much more positive message than I certainly saw another gentleman have. If I let this go on, I'm probably going to get a copyright claim. That's okay. It's a great song. Someone who is for building the wall. That's been a hot topic of late. This actually is very light. It is a weekday. You imagine this on a Saturday or Sunday. I'm on a Friday, which is getting close, but not quite the weekend. And I've been here many times before where it is when they had the street open and it's packed with people and much more protest for things. So this is a pretty light day, I think, compared to what I've seen in the past, but it still gives you a flavor of what happens here outside the White House. This is the closest the public can generally walk up to the White House. It's much further away on the other side. You really can't get close at all. So this is where people congregate to get close to the White House and, you know, take their photos and to, you know, make a political statement or reach people with a message of hope, as these people are doing, things like that. Alrighty, I think that'll do it for me here. I hope you enjoyed this video. There's certainly a colorful cast of characters out here at the White House. Well, I need to head on to the metro and head back to my office, and I will be back in Florida next week, early next week, cannot wait. Even though it's late March, almost April, it's still a little chilly here compared to what I prefer, which is why I live in Florida. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you subscribe to Lucas TV Adventures for more fun videos and interesting places, of course, almost always in Orlando, Florida, except for this one today.